Welcome back, trainers. So with the Ultra League premiere making its debut on Monday for the Go Battle League, meaning that in the Ultra League, we're not going to see any mythicals or any legendaries. So that is going to be very nice. Goodbye, Cresselia. Goodbye, Giratina, for crying out loud. Now, I've been making a lot of investments behind the scene here. As you can see, I go plus this dang 98% shiny. Are you kidding me? So, you know, I had to go ahead and max it out and purchase a secondary move. It's going to be very expensive. So Pvpoke did put together a nice graph here, kind of showing and showcasing the Pokemon that you're going to be seeing. So let's go ahead and look at this, and then we're going to go over my Pokemon as well as head over to Pvpoke to see where everything's going to be ranked. So as you can see, this is going to be the meta. You have Venusaur, Swampert, Charizard, Empoleon, Gengar, Machamp, Togekiss, Lapras, Snorlax, Abomasnow, Drifblim, and Gyarados with its newly added move Aqua Tail. And then team comps to go with them, as well as Pokemon they're going to be strong up against. All right, so let's see. Venusaur is going to be dang good, guys. All right, it is going to be ranked number one. And Swampert, as we know, is going to be a nuisance as well. But with that Venusaur roaming around, it's not going to be looking too great for it. And then, of course, you have Charizard, which is going to be combating the Venusaur, as well as several other Pokemon on the list, as well as resisting charm from the Togekiss, which is going to be very problematic as well. And then you have Drifblim roaming around, which is going to be able to lower the attack, as well as hit them pretty hard with those Shadow Balls. Abomasnow with those spammy moves. Lapras with its tankiness, as well as Snorlax. And then Machamp with its hard-hitting counter, as well as very spammable charge moves and coverage against the meta. And then you have Gyarados that is going to just be putting in work in various different situations. Now, here you have some counters to a lot of these teams that you will be seeing. We have Dragonite, which is going to be fantastic. And then Glade, which I'm very excited to use myself. I have a good IV one. And then Obstagoon, which can be a very big problem for Gengar, because it will be resisting it massively being dark and normal type. So very interesting stuff here. That's why I urge you to run probably Sludge Bomb on your Gengar. And then they did put together some example teams. We have a Venusaur, Charizard, and Swampert. Very nice elemental team there. Then we have Charizard, Lapras, and Venusaur. Dragonite, Snorlax, and Lapras. And then you have Machamp, Gengar, and Snorlax. Abomasnow, Drifblim, and Gengar. Empoleon, Glade, and Gengar. So obviously a few of these teams do have multiple weaknesses, or at least one single weakness that one specific Pokemon does have to pick up on that Pokemon that is going to be super effective against multiple of them. So say for instance, you have the Dragonite, Snorlax, and Lapras. So the Dragonite is going to be protecting the team from fighting types. So if there is a fighter in the back that you did not know of, and you handled one in the front, well, that team could have a bit of a problem. So that's what you have to think about while putting these teams together here. Moving on to Pvpoke, let's go ahead and see where everything's going to be ranking out. And then we're going to hop into my Pokemon to see what I have ready to go. So Venusaur at the top, then you have Shadow Venusaur as well. Shadow Swampert, Gengar, Machamp, and Abomasnow. So Venusaur is going to be able to handle the Swampert, the Togekiss, the Machamp, the Lapras, and a few other Pokemon, obviously getting countered by Charizard, as well as Escavalier and a few others. It's going to be calling for the standard moves, Vine Whip, Frenzy Plant, and Sludge Bomb. Now, if you want to run Razor Leaf for some reason, maybe you have a Shadow doing a ton of damage, you know, by all means, go ahead and do so, but you're going to be wanting to run that Vine Whip. Then moving down the list here, we have Gengar. Wow, let's get it. Finally, time for it to shine. Now, we don't have too many normal types roaming around. We have a few darks, which can be problematic, and like we've discussed, you may want to run Sludge Bomb, right? Going all Ghost is a bit risky, but if they don't have anything that is going to be resisting that, you should be looking pretty good, but you don't want to take that risk. But by all means, run all Ghost moves if you so choose to. All right, so Gengar, fantastic, awesome. Community Day move, of course, with Shadow Punch. Moving down the list, we have several others. This is going to be another interesting one as well. Honchkrow here, this is going to be a dark type. So obviously good against Venusaur and a few others there. So very glassy Pokemon, so keep that in mind. Taking a look at Drifblim, it is going to be massively resisting fighting, and it is going to be able to combat the top Pokemon, Venusaur, as well as a few other hard-hitting Pokemon that you're going to be seeing. But it is going to be getting countered by quite a few Pokemon that you will be seeing often in the Ultra League Premier Cup as well. Drifblim is going to be fantastic. Excited for that, as well as possibly the Flying Cup for the Ultra League as well. See, we'll have to wait and see the details on that. So Machamp, I'm really excited for this one here. I was about to power up another Shadow, but I just decided to just stick with the Ultra League one that I do have. It's not the best IVs around. As a matter of fact, it's got like 15 attack. Really good IVs, but that's not exactly what you want for the Ultra League for Machamp. And apparently the regular Machamp is going to be performing a little bit better than the Shadow. And then we have Abomasnow, another very expensive investment because it is going to have to be maxed out. Good up against several good Pokemon, Swampert, Venusaur, Togekiss, Gengar, Dragonite, losing to Fire, of course, Charizard, then Machamp, Lapras, Escavalier, Poliwrath. It's going to be calling for Powdered Snow, Weather Ball, and Energy Ball. So you're going to be able to spam those charge moves at an extreme rate, but it does have to look out for Fire. They will be destroying it. Shadow Gyarados looking great. Good up against Swampert, Charizard, Escavalier, Empoleon, and Dragonite. So unfortunately, I did not evolve my Shadow Magikarp yesterday. I think I was just caught up in the live stream, unfortunately. Yikes. But I'm not too worried about it. Whatever. We're good here. So we do have that Snorlax at 18 Shadow. So something that the Gengar has to worry about, of course, resisting the ghost moves while dishing out super effective with the lick. And that will add up very quick, seeing that Gengar is very squishy, even if it does shield up. Body slam, not very effective. Superpower, not very effective. It doesn't really matter. That lick is going to add up. And if you're stuck there with just ghost moves, well, you're donezo. You're donezo, folks. All right. And that's why I urge you to run Sludge Bomb. But hey, what do I know? So taking a look at a few others here. Glade looking great. This is one that I'm very excited for. Confusion is going to be super effective to that Gengar, but at the same time taking super effective damage right back from it with those ghost moves. Moving down the list, looking real beautiful. I'm excited for this. We have even a Staraptor around 50. So this one is a very interesting one. It does have Brave Bird, which has been recently buffed, but also going to dramatically lower your stats when used. And also close combat. So it's like Staraptor is a very risky Pokemon because both of its moves that you're going to be wanting to run are going to debuff you to some degree. So unfortunately, that's why I want this to get a community day of some sort. I think Staraptor needs a quick move, to be honest with you, because it has great charge moves. It's just not pulling it up for the quick move with that quick attack there. Anyways, moving it on down the list here, as you can see, moving it up to the high 60s and 70s. So it's looking pretty good, guys. Now let's go ahead and take a look at some Machamps and see what we have, comparing them here. So as you can see, the regular Machamp is going to be performing a little bit better than the Shadow, but that's not to say the Shadow Machamp is not going to be great, which is going to be fantastic, dealing so much damage, but also being a little bit squishier if you are not familiar. Shadow Pokemon are going to take a little bit more damage, but also dish out a little bit more. And taking a look at all of my Ultra League Pokemon that I do have ready to go here, have quite a few, as well as an Altaria and a Skarmory completely maxed out. The Altaria is actually going to be a best buddy. Has horrible IVs, but I'm just gearing up for the Mega Evolution, possibly if that's the way it's going to be going. As you can see here, this is the very bottom line. We could keep going down with other things I have maxed out, but let's just go right back up to the top here. So quite a few contenders that are going to be able to enter into the Premier Cup for the Ultra League. And some people were asking me, what am I going to main with? What am I excited to use? Well, Abomasnow, Drifblim, Glade, Gengar. I have so many good things. I'm excited for all of them. But really what I'm looking forward to is Gengar, Glade, and the Drifblim. As well as several others, which I'm going to keep a secret for now. We'll just have to see when the video comes out, whenever I drop that, what I'm actually going to be using. So that's my Machamp there. Horrible IVs, but whatever. It is what it is. We're just going to be doing that much more damage with our moves, right? I even have a Kangaskhan for some reason. That was an expensive investment, but I did it anyways. And then we have this Glade here. Pretty good IVs. I have a better IV one, but it is in the Great League. Might as well just keep it there, right? We don't need to get to that rank one, even though it could help you. And this is our Staraptor. We do have with that secondary move. Unfortunately, I will be testing it out, but it's not going to be the best with those debuffs for both of its charge moves. Empoleon is going to be fantastic. That's going to be a rank 3 or so. Poliwrath, not the best rank. And a whole bunch of other Pokemon that I've made in between throughout the years. Just just doing that, just to test things out. Some of them before I knew about the PvP IVs, or any of us knew about PvP IVs, so I do have a few that have a lot of attack. I did transfer that Gyarados because secondary move is cheap, and I just don't want it to pop up on my recommended. If I wanted to do auto rec or something like that, I don't want that Gyarados popping up anymore. So let's just get rid of it, because we do have the one that we made yesterday, Starscream, the shiny, looking good with decent IVs. Obstagoon, I have that ready to go. So many Pokemon that I can't wait to test out here. Gengar looking great. So this is not going to be the community day Gengar. We're actually going to go ahead and make one of those right now. Really good Swampert over there. This is going to be my great, or Ultra League. Did I say Great League? Ultra League Gengar. And there we go, bought that secondary move. We're just spending dust, we don't even think about it. And we are geared up and ready to go. So hopefully this gave you a little bit of an insight on what you should be preparing for and Pokemon you want to be using for the Ultra League Premier Cup in Pokemon Go. Thank you for watching, trainers. If you did enjoy it, give it a big thumbs up. And Lucario is looking great too. Let's go. Take care.